This is a professional video tutorial for how to create circles with GIMP. This is GIMP, the great image manipulation program. There are multiple ways to create perfect circles and beautiful circles with GIMP. The most simple one is to use the elliptical selection tool. Click the elliptical selection tool in the toolbox. Click. Then right click in the image surface or picture surface. You see, now you can select a circle, an elliptical shape, long. If you want to have a perfect round circle, press the shift button and hold it. Press and hold. GIMP will make sure if you press and hold the shift button on the keyboard that the circle is perfect round, 100%. So let's select a circle here. Okay, selected, and then you can move the selection in the center. Okay, now this is a circle selection. Now you can fill the selection with color or an image or pattern, but I'll use a color for fun. Okay, click the color box in here, and I'll choose the red. Okay, this red. Okay, red, and then just click the color and drag, put it in the selection. I just create a new layer for the circle, new layer, okay, and then pull the color in the new layer into the circle selection. Okay, here is a perfect round circle. Then Control Shift A to remove the selection, and I'll just move this circle one again with the move tool. Circle is in the middle on the white. Now this is Japan, the flag of Japan. Okay, Japan to the side. Okay, there is another way to create a circle, just the outline of the circle, an empty circle. Let's do this in another empty layer. Okay, so the selection tool again, elliptic round. Okay, let's choose bigger one, then hold shift button, and then okay, release buttons, and then it is a selection round, perfect. And then now we just want to have the edges of the circle. Okay, there is multiple ways to do this. This is one of them. You just right click on the image and go to the edit menu, and then go to the stroke selection. This is a little bit silly, This stroke selection tool should be in the selection menu of GIMP, but not in this version yet, maybe in the future. So in this GIMP version you have this stroke selection tool dialog in the edit menu. So stroke selection, click OK, and then you have multiple ways to create a outline of the circle, a stroke, a brush stroke or a pencil stroke. You can stroke a line, or I like to stroke with a paint tool or pencil, paintbrush, eraser, airbrush, ink. Let's do ink. Here is the ink. Okay, I clicked the ink button and then the selection went away once again. That is okay. If you want to preset the ink tool before you make the stroke, you preset it here. Just press the ink tool and then choose the tool options tab of the toolbox dialog, and then I can go for 20 pixels. Okay, 20 pixels of the calligraphy ink tool. Okay, and then next time, okay, now select once again the circle. Okay, hold shift. Okay, and then right click on the image, edit stroke selection, stroke with paint tool. Okay, ink emulate brush dynamics. Yes, okay, stroke. Okay, now you see it's stroke. Then control shift A to remove the selection. Okay, this is a perfect stroke. Looks like a stain, coffee stain. Okay, no, coffee stain. Okay, let's see why you could use something like this. Let's use a brush. Click. Oh, control Z for back, or click. Okay, this is a smiley face, a circle and a smiley face. Very nice. Okay. Now shoot. If you want to move a circle, you should click on the circle surface, not on the empty space. Okay, control Z for back. Okay, circle surface. Okay, move here the circle. Okay, let's have a short way of creating a circle with GIMP. Let's use a new layer. Here in the layer dialog, layer part of the GIMP program, click new layer. Okay, and let's use the elliptic selection tool again, then hold shift and drag selection for selecting circle. Okay, now we have a selection, and this time we can use just the outline of the edge of the circle. Let's use just the outline. For this you can use the selection menu. Just right click on the image, go to the selection menu, and then go to the border. just the border of the selection. Border click, and we see how much we want of the border of the circle. Maybe 11 pixels, and then feather border. Yes, okay, feather, make a softer border. Okay, and then it will choose a border outline of the selection. Let's click OK. The selection is probably there, but not visible because it is too soft. Let's see. Here, if you click here in the quick mask of the selection, you can still see that there is a selection, but it is too soft to be seen without the quick mask tool. It is there. Just deactivate the quick mask tool. Check. Okay, let's drag a color into this non-visible border of the circle in the image. It is there inside of the selection. Let's just drag it from here and release. Okay, you see it's there. Now it is a softer circle, just a ring. Somehow a lot of jiggle pixel. Let me see if we can do the same, but without the this pixel artifact. Let's try to have a new layer and then try to have a ring. Hold shift. Let's try with a paintbrush, maybe. Edit, stroke selection tool, and let's stroke with a paintbrush tool and emulate brush dynamics. Okay. No, Control Z. Let's try without brush dynamics in the stroke selection. Okay. Stroke. Yes. Good. Oh, this is better. A lot better. This is perfect without noisy artifacts. This is a ring. And the stroke selection tool, it uses the settings from the paint tools. You can set them in the tool options box here. Tab, tool options tab. Oh, it was a 44 pixel brush size. This is why it is so a big ring. So okay, these are the 1, 2, 3, 4 different ways of creating circles and rings with GIMP. You just remember to hold the shift button if you want to have your perfect circles. If you don't want this, you can have non-perfect fun circles like this, maybe yellow one. Okay, yellow. Choose another one. Green. Another one. Super green. Okay. This is quite psychedelic. You can use this for fun or as an art project. Okay, But there is also a more fun way to create circles in GIMP. This is a picture of a beautiful woman. Okay, and you can use circles on this picture. You should know GIMP. GIMP is great for image manipulation. It is not so good for drawing. If you want to draw, you better use LibreOffice Draw or Paint, or in the Linux, the Free Paint or Inkscape for drawing, for professional drawing. GIMP is for manipulating images and for some simple drawings like arrow or dot smiley. Let's say you draw an image of circles in some other software or program, and then you move it to GIMP and then you want to edit it. This is what GIMP is for editing. It is the best software for manipulating images, for editing. Let's see. Combined here, let's just right click in the layer tab, combine the layers. Okay, it's a whole image now. And then let's just manipulate this image. You cannot do this in all other software, but GIMP is perfect for this. Just right click, for example, colorize, and just hue, colorize, saturation, lightness, and then colors, posterize. Okay, this is what GIMP is for manipulating ready images. So let's see a image or picture photograph and see how you can manipulate a photograph with circles in GIMP. Okay, this is a very nice costume. I'll create a new layer for the circles of, and then let's just use a red, nice red color for the circles and rings, and then use the selection, elliptic selection tool, and create some circles like here one, and then drag color, and then okay, here one, and drag color, and then here one, drag color, here, okay, here maybe one, color, two, color, here one big circle, this color. Here maybe one small, here one other one, okay, here one long circle, here a small, or here another one, okay. Here more circles, maybe here one, big one, yes, big one, should be big, okay, then here one, and here one, okay, here circles around here, here, okay, now we have circles. bubbles and rings, no, rings, circles. Now, see, that's the fun. Without circles, with circles, this is fun. Let's do it even more fun. Let's set the transparency or the opacity of the circles layer to, let's say, 50%. Okay, here in the opacity section of the layers tab, let's zoom in with control and then wheel of the mouse, zoom in and then edit some more. Let's use the elliptic selection tool and just select the skin parts under this ring or of that are under this circle layer, and then just select any part and then click the delete button. It will just delete color. Okay, here delete, here some delete, delete, delete here, delete here, 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 delete everywhere where you can see only the skin, no clothes, no jewelry. This is fun. Okay, just make this little bubble circles everywhere. This is called bubbling. This is very interesting and a fun activity. If you like circles in GIMP, then this is probably the most useful thing to do with circles in GIMP. Just create these little circles and bubbles everywhere where you can only see the skin under the color bubble layer. Okay, just select with the elliptic tool, select and click delete, select, 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 delete everywhere, small bubble circles everywhere. This is fun. Okay, here some in the center, here, okay, here bigger one, here, okay, here some, here one interesting one, here a small one, small, okay. Okay, let's see the result. Control shift A for removing selection. Okay, let's have the opacity to 100% again and you see the result. This is just the bubbles, circles, rings, you see. And this is on the right, just the bubbles. On the right, left, some bubbles with holes. Fun, interesting. Let's do some more holes and circles and bubbles. Let's set opacity to 50%. Okay, some more. Select, delete, select, circle, delete, 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 select, delete, select, delete, select, delete, select, and delete, 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 just to have more skin and less color. Okay, here one, here, here, everywhere where the skin is. Okay, okay, here, here, okay, here some, here one, it's like cheese, Swiss cheese, Swiss mountain cheese, holes, bubbles and holes everywhere, empty circle. I can bet you never have seen empty circles this fun. Okay, but here's some in the belly. Okay, beautiful. Okay. Almost done. Could be more holes and circles and bubbles, but it's okay. See, now this is perfect. You see the effect with circles and bubbles and without. Click without and with. Nice. This is very good for imagination. Click, click, click with, without. So circles are fun. Let's see a square, like square selection here, square, red color square, and a circle, round, elliptic selection. Then click shift and the center, and okay, and then let's have a selection, circle, round, circle selection, and then click delete. Okay, now it is a white circle. It chose the white because it is the background color. And if you don't have transparency in the layer, it will just choose white instead of transparent. But you see, you can create a square with a circle in the middle. And this is how you create circles and bubbles and rings in GIMP, the great image manipulation program. Thank you for supporting the Linux movement. Thank you for supporting the free software movement. And thank you for supporting the Creative Commons movement. Have fun.